Hey guys, welcome back. It's been a while. It's been more than 5 months since I've posted a video, and you can probably tell that my background has also changed because we've moved. I'm still in Sydney, but we've moved closer to the city, into a new apartment. And I did do a moving vlog for it, but in my Filipino channel. So if any of you speak or understand Tagalog, then you might want to go over there to watch that video. But if not, then that's totally cool. Let me know if you want me to do a house tour for you guys, and I will go ahead and do that. Now, I just wanted to come on here and give you a life update, just to explain where I've been, what I've been doing, and why I haven't been on YouTube for a while. And to be perfectly honest, it's very straightforward and simple, the reason why I haven't been uploading. And it's essentially because I just really don't have that motivation anymore. Makeup doesn't excite me as much as it used to. I am no longer the hoarder that I was. I mean, don't get me wrong, I still have a lot of makeup. I've kept a lot of the ones that I love still in my collection, but as you can probably tell with the minimal makeup that I have today, I don't even have my like false lashes on. And that's mainly because it just doesn't resonate with me anymore. And also, I've been transitioning, as you've known, in the last maybe 1 or 2 years to becoming a little bit more of a conscious consumer, especially seeing all of that garbage that's been floating around my country, and Indonesia, and basically in Southeast Asia. That's the great big plastic crisis that we have. And honestly, buying all of these makeup, all of the unnecessary packaging that it comes with, and like, it just, I think it's just really wasteful. So I have moved away from that. I do still buy a few things here and there that I want to try. Stocking up on holy grails. Every time I do, I buy something, it's always usually because I've already run out or am running out of a product that I really love. So I haven't really been buying just for the sake of trying things out or trying a new formula or reviewing things, as you can probably tell. The other thing that I have stepped back significantly from is hauling clothes. I still do buy clothes, especially because there are different seasons here in Australia, particularly here in Sydney. As you can probably tell, I am wearing a sweater because down under it's winter. In fact, it's about 15 degrees outside. It will drop to something around 7 or 8 tonight, so it's kind of cold where I am currently. Where the northern hemisphere is having their spring and summer, we here on the southern hemisphere are having our winter and fall. Winter and fall. So yeah, I have been shopping a few things that are seasonal, but this particular shirt that I'm wearing right now, the sweatshirt, this is the third winter that I'm wearing it. And that's something that I have also realized, is that buying clothes and then discarding them after using them for one season was just not something that I want to do. In fact, a lot of the things that I'm wearing this winter are things that I have taken out of storage, and will be using for probably the second or at least, yeah, the third or second winter at least. I haven't really bought any winter clothes this time around because I knew that I had quite a few still. I do have here a new pair of Doc Martens that are the winter grip ones, the ones that are lined with faux fur, just because my Uggs need to be retired. So yeah, but other than that, it's really been, I do have quite a collection of shoes, I'm not gonna lie about that. Shoes are probably the one thing that I just can't say no to, but I am trying my best to reduce that. I've even had this policy that if I am going to bring in a new pair, I have to let go of an old one. Whether it's by donating it or reselling it into like Facebook markets or like weekend markets here in Sydney, then I will do that. Because I honestly, a few things that I have actually been experiencing is because I've started following all of these influencers on Instagram who are about secondhand clothing and thrifting and essentially reusing and recycling or upcycling garments. That's the one thing that, like, whenever I feel the urge that I want to shop, I go to a thrift store or to a Salvation Army or what we call Salvos here or Vinnie's, which is the St. Vincent de Paul charity shops. Or I go to vintage clothing areas, especially here in Newtown. They've got U-Turn, Cream on King, and a few other shops that sell secondhand vintage clothing. And rummaging through them and finding little gems in those huge stacks of clothing is really something that is motivating for me and challenging, and I find that it makes me feel more fulfilled than going into, say, for example, H&M or Zara and knowing that I will find my size in the style that I have or that I want, or I could at least wait for that. Yeah, the challenge of thrifting is quite exhilarating for me, so now I prefer to actually do that. I thrift tops, jackets, outerwear, bottoms, jeans in particular. I thrift that. I also buy from eBay secondhand clothing instead of buying new. Yeah, the only things that I probably would continue to buy new would be obviously underwear, because swimwear too, but I've got a shit ton of swimwear, so I probably won't be buying any at all come this summer. And then shoes, unless I find shoes in the charity shops that are really good condition, like no molds or fungus or whatever, because who wants that in their shoes? But if I don't find good condition ones, then I'm gonna buy new. But really think about making that purchase if I really need it. So yeah, that's a lot of talking just to update you guys. But yeah, that's what I've been experiencing so far. This need to, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, I still get the urge to do shopping, but that's why now that I've discovered thrifting and discovered buying secondhand, instead of me actually browsing through the websites of Mango or Zara or H&M or whatever, I actually go on eBay and find secondhand stuff. Because let's be honest, everything that we could possibly imagine that we want to wear has already been created at one point or another, and it's out there in the world. We just need to find where it is, and one man's or one woman's or one person's trash is another person's treasure. And that's exactly what I have found with thrifting, is that I started finding all of these things that people have let go of that needed a new home, and I actually really like it, especially with jeans that are, like, for example, Levi's 501s that are really strong denim. Like, they don't have a lot of stretch. Once they've been lived in and been used, they are just much more comfortable, and I don't really mind that because I can wash it. I can wash it like how many times before I wear them. If I was icky that way, but I'm not. Like, I grew up in a third world country. These things are pretty normal to me. I don't get sick that easily, or you know what I mean. But anyway, yeah. So I'm not iffy. I'm not fuzzy about stuff like that. I wouldn't mind wearing. And I'm the youngest of five. Most of my clothes growing up were hand-me-downs, so it's not really an issue for me. But I just wanted to bring that out there. If any of you guys are into thrifting or buying secondhand and stuff like that, or if you're not, yeah, maybe this video would influence you to think about that, because really the effect that fashion and fast fashion in particular is having on our planet is tremendously, I mean, it's a crisis. And we need to start doing something about it. So this is my small way of doing it. There's a lot of things that I can still improve on, but slowly and surely I am trying to do better in terms of that. And I hope you guys are as well. We've always recycled in this home. We've always segregated our garbage to make sure that we can put as little into landfills as possible and reuse and recycle stuff. I don't go to the grocery shop and use single-use plastics. I have my own bags that are reusable that I bring with me all the time. It's my little way of helping out the planet, because the truth is, the planet is going to survive all of this. It's our survival that we need to think about, because what we're doing to the planet is making it impossible to sustain human life. And once we become extinct, the planet is going to recover. It's going to recuperate, and it's going to be able to host other forms of life long after we're gone. So if you think that we're killing the planet, that's not 100% accurate. Who we are really killing here is ourselves. All right? So that's just a message that I want to get out there. And if you guys are into this journey as well, please let me know what are some of the things that you have done to slowly help reduce the problem that we have with waste, the problem that we have with this climate change. Maybe I can learn some tips from you guys that I can pick up and start doing in my own life. And yeah, let's start sharing ideas on how we can help keep human life on this earth. That's all. That's a really long update, but yeah. Let me know also what videos you want to see in the next ones. I probably will put up a video of my jeans collection, and my most of which are thrifted or secondhand, and maybe an update on my shoe collection if you guys are interested. But other than that, yeah, thanks for watching. Thank you for sticking around after my 5 months absence, and hopefully I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.